Hey y'all, it's Steve, Hobo with Wood. This video, I'm going to be playing with scissors. I'll be seated, so I won't be running with scissors. But I'm going to be trying to figure out the new tool in Lightburn, the scissor node editing tool. We're going to play with it, figure out what it does, how it does, when it does, what it does, and do a little bit of learning together. So stay tuned. So I played with this just a little bit, and I kind of got an idea of what's going on with it and how it works, but I still struggle with it sometimes because it like all things in Lightburn, in order to work the way you want it to, it has to meet certain criteria. It has to have lines crossing this or that, or intersect here or there, and when certain parameters aren't met, it will give you results that you weren't looking for. And that's when I like just using the node editing tool. But if you know what those parameters are and you know what to look for, the scissor tool can be quicker at times. So we're going to create an earth globe on a stand, tilted on its axis, and we're going to do it using just primitive tools, the radius tool, primitive shapes, the radius tool, rotate tool, and the scissors. We're going to try and refrain from using any node editing, and we're going to do this all from scratch and using nothing but Lightburn. And actually, I'll probably go over and grab an SVG of just the Western Hemisphere, because while I can probably get something that's close to a North and South American continent, I ain't gonna go to that trouble. I'll just copy it from a map and bring that on and put that on the globe. So without further ado, let's jump into Lightburn and play with some scissors. So like I said, I'm going to create a globe. And I'm going to try and do it with all primitive shapes. And it's going to be one that's mounted on a spinning axis. So let's come right here and draw out a perfect circle. Go about like that. Actually, you know what? I want to see what size we got here. We're going to make it, we'll make it 8 inches. Okay. And that'll be relevant in a few minutes. Let's put it on a toolpath, or not a toolpath, but in line mode. Now that's 8 inches. Let's go back to millimeters. And we're going to duplicate that. Control D, duplicate it, and bring it out holding the control button to about there. Just eyeballing it. I'm going to duplicate that again and bring it out to about there, and then how big is that? That is 228. Let's just make it an even 229. All right. And now let's draw a straight line coming here, shift and hold it straight down and draw a straight line. In fact, I'll come down a little bit further. That's fine. Oh, I didn't. Hold shift. There we go. Click and stop. Now let's put that in the very center of the outermost piece, and let's have it be if it was 229, we want to bring this one, we'll go 5, go 10 millimeters, 239. So put our anchor point in the middle, because we've got our line centered up in that globe, so we want to keep it centered up, and we're going to tell it to be 239 mil in there. That works. Now with that centered up, I'm going to rotate it negative 23.5 degrees, because that's the angle of the Earth's rotation in round numbers. And now let's actually we're going to duplicate that. Control D, duplicate. And move arrows 10 millimeters of work. Arrow it over. Oh, come on, select it and arrow it over. That'll work. And let's see, what else do I want to do? I want to do an offset of this one. And that actually looks okay. 10 mil looks good. And let's do square instead of round, or corners, I should say. There, that's better. And delete the original. Good. Now, I'm just designing in my head here. Let's grab a rectangle. Let's come down here and start building our base. And let's put that one in the center. And then Alt-Shift-V to bring it close. And then we need to move it just a little bit above that to, so that it will fully cut out there. So I'm going to hold my control button and up arrow and bring that up to there. And if you don't know how to set your fine measurement or fine movement, you go in your settings, and this is 1703. You've got a new set of tabs for menus, units and grids. Your control arrow is, I use it for my finest movement, and I've got it at 0.02. Shift arrow 1 millimeter, and then 10 millimeters on my other. So there's that. And now let's do another rectangle. And I'm going to come right here and get my little bullseye in my mouse, right? That lets me know I'm on the very center of that. And by coming there and holding control and start drawing out, it's going to draw out in equal distances. It'll draw out equal distance that way or equal distance that way. But it's not forced to be square. If I combine it with the shift button, then it'll be a perfect square. And I don't want a square, I just want to be, and I didn't want to let go of it there. I needed to zoom out. Let's try it again. I want to zoom out a little bit, come here, and I want to come up to about there, I think. Come here and get my middle again, and now I'm going to do the same thing to about there. And then one more time. And this one I'm going to bring out about there. All right. You starting to see a globe? I am. All right. Now I need to put a button up here and here. So I'm going to come right here in the middle, and I'm going to hold my control and the shift and draw out a circle to about there. Come over here, same thing, draw out a circle, and it's going to overlap to, we'll go about there. And now I'm going to come down here and do the same thing here. Shift and control and draw out a circle to about there. I'm not going to worry about a button on the bottom of it. All right, now let's start using our scissors. Now, normally I would use my weld tools and node editing to start putting all this together, but we're going to try and do all of this with scissors. So scissors, and we'll come over here. I don't need this or this or even this. That can go away. Up here, I don't need this or this. That. Here, I don't need that or that or, oh, and I don't have that circle low enough, so it didn't weld up. So let's undo that. And let's grab that circle and just bring it, holding my control, and we'll bring it down to where it overlaps right about there. Is that what I want to do? Or don't, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to bring it up here. Like that. That's what I'm going to do. And do scissors again. And just trim that away and that away. And then that. And for engraving purposes, that's got to go. And same thing down here, 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 here. And now let's go down here to our base. Let's zoom in tight and get rid of that and that. All right, now we have a globe. I'm going to fancy up our base using the radius tool, and I want to maximize these radiuses, but I'm going to use a regular radius here, and then I'm going to use a concave radius here, and then a regular radius out here, and I want to maximize these two, and the biggest they can possibly be would be the length of the whatever the shortest of these are. That one measures 12.96, that one 16.86. So 12.96 is as large as it can be. So I'm gonna say okay and go to my radius tool and tell it to be 12.96 and come right here to that corner. Come on and select that and then go here. What happened? What in the world did that do? Undo. That ain't what I was expecting to happen. That ain't right. Something's going screwy there. Let's just do that down to 10 millimeters and see if I have the same result. Nope. 12.96 was max, but it was too much for it. Let's do 12.9. That'll work. Now let's do a ruler here. That one's 13.68 and that one's 12.96 again. So we'll do 12.9, but we're going to do this one concave. So we've still got 12.9, but I need it to be a negative 12.9. Negative 12.9. And we'll do that one here and here. And then this one, I want to do half the distance over its overall height. And the overall height is 26.4, so 13.2. 13.2, and a radius there and there. And I'm not hating that little bit of a step out right there. In fact, if I wanted to make that a little bit more, this is where I have to use node editing. I could have corrected it while I was doing the initial radius, but instead of undoing and backing up all the way to that point, I'll go into node editing, and I'm going to grab everything about that radius, which is starting there to there. And my shift arrow is 1 millimeter. So I'm going to go 1, 2, 3. And I'll come over here and do the same thing. I'll grab and go 1, 2, 3. And take a look now at that. All right. That looks pretty good. Now, instead of trying, and which you could use the line mode and draw out something that looks vaguely like a landmass. I'm just simply going to paste in a copy of a map. And now I'm going to see if I can trace it out like it is without having to mess with the gamma and the darkness. And yeah, that'll work right there. And say okay. Ungroup it. I don't need that outer piece. Let's group this back together, and we're going to tell it we did that initial circle at 8 inches. So let's tell this one to be 8 inches. We're going to unlock that aspect ratio and tell it to go 8 and 8. I messed that up. Try it again. Fat fingered 8 and 8. There we go. Lock the aspect ratio back. Now with that, I'm going to center it up on, well, I don't know if center, we'll try, no, because it's gonna be off center because that's not gonna work. So we're just gonna grab that from the center and bring it over here and snap it right there. Now ungroup it, come up here and grab that and delete it. And now I've got my landmass, and I think we're good. Now, if I was going, this is on a red and a line mode. If I put it in fill mode, put it in engrave mode. If that's not the image you want to engrave, if you want the inverse of that, then you would simply create duplicates. So let's go back to align mode so that we can see what I'm doing. Put that in line, and I'm going to select everything except the landmass, so that right there. And just say Control D, duplicate that, and then grab all of it and put it on the black layer, and that's what you get. So the scissors tool's pretty cool. I mean, it actually incorporates node editing and Boolean and close path. It does a lot when it does what it does. So I imagine the programming required to make that tool happen was, they had to do a little forethought and figure things out. But you gotta recognize that when you trim it, it's gonna, if you only want it to go to a certain distance, it has to have a line, a demarcation line where it's gonna stop where it's cutting at. Otherwise, it's just gonna cut the, it'll work as a delete tool. It's cool. I'll play with it more and probably use it more and like it more, but I enjoy my node editing. Hope you learned a little bit. I'm learning as I go with this. I just downloaded this 1.7.03 last week, and this is really the first time I've played with that. And I've still got some learning to do. But I hope you found this a little bit informative, a little bit entertaining. I'm Steve, Hobo with Wood, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.